Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to discuss about the prokaryotic cell. In previous session, we have discussed about the comparison between the prokaryotic and eukaryotic. Okay, so today we'll be talking of the prokaryotic cell. So, see, as we have already defined the prokaryotic cell, what is it? The cell which is without the well-developed cellular organelles are referred as the prokaryotic cell, right? So, let's talk about the prokaryotic cell in detail. Okay, so prokaryotic cell. So in prokaryotic cell, we are supposed to discuss about the example of the example. That example is of the the bacterial cell. Okay, so we'll be talking of the example bacterial cell. Okay, so when we talk of the bacteria, basically bacteria are the cosmopolitan. Okay, cosmopolitan in the sense what? They are found everywhere. Okay, they are found everywhere. So they are referred as the cosmopolitan. And bacterial cell are the more primitive type of cell. So what most of the experiments, okay, are also been performed on these bacterial cells. So what it is important to understand the nature of the bacterial cell or the prokaryotic cell. Okay, so prokaryotic cells are those which are having very less well developed cellular organelles, as well as there is the absence of the membrane bound organelle, that is called as the prokaryotic cell. And the name itself indicates, pro means primitive and karyotic means nucleus. That means the cells which are having the very primitive type of nucleus is called as the prokaryotic cell. Okay, so this is what about it. Now let's talk of the occurrence, where exactly these are occurred. Occurrence. Okay, so prokaryotes are placed in kingdom monera. Okay, so commonly called as monerans. So commonly called as monerans. These includes bacteria, comma cyanobacteria, which is also referred as the blue-green algae, BGA, that is blue-green algae. Cyanobacteria is also referred as blue-green algae, comma mycoplasma, or which is also referred as the PPLO. We have studied about it, that is the smallest organism, that is pleuropneumonia like microorganism, is called as the PPLO. Okay, then spirochetes, comma, and rickettsia or rickettsii. Okay, and rickets. So these are the some of the prokaryotes, okay, or the bacteria. So prokaryotes, they are basically placed under kingdom Monera. Okay, so there are five kingdom classification system has been put forward by a scientist called R.H. Whittaker. Okay, according to him, there are the organisms can be classified into five different classes, okay, or five different kingdoms. on the basis of their mode of nutrition, on the basis of their complexity of the cell, presence of the nucleus or absence of the nucleus, then the type of mode of reproduction and all. Okay, so such characteristic features are there. On what basis we are classifying the living organisms? And prokaryotes are the living organisms or the cells which are classified under kingdom Monera. Okay, so these are commonly called as the Monerans. Okay, now these Monerans includes the bacteria, cyanobacteria, mycoplasma, spirochetes and rickettsiae. So these are the some bacterias or the examples of the prokaryotes. Okay, so bacteria, we know that bacteria, they are cosmopolitan, they are found in each and every environment. Like some of the bacteria, they are also been supposed to live in extreme conditions. Okay, and such bacteria are called as the archaebacteria. Okay, so the bacteria which are supposed to live in extreme condition, okay, so bacteria can be the archaebacteria, or eubacteria. Now, what is the difference between archaebacteria and eubacteria? See, most of the bacteria, see, when the earth was formed or when the life was originated, the first life, okay, at that time the environment or the atmosphere of the earth was very hot, and the organism or the microorganism which were supposed to be live on such environment, okay, or in such environment, okay, were called the extremophiles. That means extremophiles means extreme condition loving microorganisms. Okay, so they are supposed to grow in the extreme conditions. So what they are referred as the archaebacteria or the archaebacteria. Okay, and here archaebacteria have three different categories. One is called as the methanogens means what? Those microorganisms which are responsible for conversion of the organic waste into the methane gas. Okay, we study this type of methanogens into the biogas production also, or generally it is also referred as gobar gas production, right? Then apart from that, they have the halophiles means what? See, those bacteria which are supposed to grow or live under high salt concentration. Okay, wherever there is high salt concentration, at such regions some microorganism or bacteria are capable of growing. These are called halophiles. Halo means salt and philes means loving, salt loving bacteria. Then we have the thermophiles or thermoacidophiles. Okay, these are called thermophiles. Means those bacteria which are supposed to live at greater temperatures. Okay, some bacteria, they are found in the hot springs. Okay, that means they are supposed to live under high temperature region, and they are supposed to carry out their metabolic activities at same temperature. Okay, they can be found in the hot spring or the hot water boiling, okay, that is around 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, they can live in that temperature, right? And they can also perform their metabolic activity. So what called as the thermophile? Thermo means temperature and philes means loving. So temperature loving bacteria. Okay, so these are called archaebacteria. And eubacteria means, eu means true. So eubacteria are those bacteria which are supposed to live in the normal conditions. Okay, like the mesophilic temperature, that varies from the 25 degrees Celsius to 37 degrees Celsius. Okay, in such a condition these are able to grow, that is called eubacteria. Okay, still, so as far as occurrence is concerned, prokaryotes, they occur in various different forms. Okay, so here the different forms are there. Now cyanobacteria is also a eubacteria. Okay, and it is also referred as blue green algae, as it is found in the marshy land. Marshy means wherever there is the abundance of water is there. You can take an example of paddy fields. Paddy means that is the rice fields, right? Wherever we cultivate the rice crops. So, in that paddy field, there is an abundance of water is there. okay, and blue green algae is capable of growing in such a condition. So what it will fix the atmospheric nitrogen. So it is a kind of helpful bacteria, you can say. Okay, so it help in the fixation of the atmospheric nitrogen. Now you know atmospheric nitrogen, what it does, it help in the growth and development of the plants, okay, or the crops. So basically nitrogen is, it is a very much important metabolite or nutrient which is required by the plant's growth and development. As it is helping in the development of the chlorophyll pigment, it is required for protein synthesis, it is required for formation of nucleic acids, okay. So all these components are having the nitrogen, even the amino acids, proteins, right, vitamins, vital amines, that means they are also having the nitrogen derivative. So basically it is very much important, nitrogen. So that nitrogen will be fixed with the help of the cyanobacteria. Then mycoplasma, smallest microorganism, okay, that is the size of 0.1 micrometer, or which is also called as pleuropneumonia-like organism, okay. Then spirochetes, we will discuss about the structure and their particular appearance and what these spirochetes do. So these are also involved in formation of certain diseases, causing certain diseases. Rickettsia, these are also causing the rickettsia, a disease, okay. So some are useful bacteria, some are harmful bacteria, okay. So this is what about the occurrence, fine. You can pause the video and note down these points, okay. So bacteria were first discovered by, okay, it was first discovered by the Antony von Leeuwenhoek, okay. You know Antony von Leeuwenhoek, we have discussed about it in previous class during the introductory part, okay. The next point, next to the occurrence, is the size, okay. Size of bacteria. So bacteria, they vary in the size, okay, that is from 0.15, okay, that is 0.15 to 0.3 micrometer in diameter, and this dimension or this size is for, okay, diameter of, that is a bacterium called Dialister. Bacterium called Dialister. Okay. And spirochetes, they have the size approximately 500 micrometer. This is a unit, mu. It is also called mu or the micrometer. Okay. So 500 micrometer. Okay, that is the largest bacterium, that is spirochetes. Okay, spirochetes. And normally the size is, okay, normally the size of bacteria's is 0.3 to 15 micrometer, okay, that is the normal size of the bacteria's. Now here there are certain variations like 0.15 to 0.3 micrometer in diameter of Dialister bacteria. Then 500 micrometer, that is the largest bacterium called spirochetes, and the normal size or the normally size of the bacteria is the 0.3 to 15 micrometer. Okay, that will be the size of the bacteria. Okay, the next, shape. Now bacteria vary in different shapes. Okay, they may be the spherical or they may be the rod shape. If they are spherical, they are referred as cocci, and if they are rod shaped, they are referred as bacilli, okay. So let's see, you can pause the video and note down this point of the size, okay? Shape. So a scientist called E. J. Cohen, okay, recognized four shapes of bacteria. Four shapes of bacteria, okay, which includes number one, coccus. Okay, coccus. Then number two, bacillus. Number three, spirillum. And number four is the vibrio. Okay, so these are the four structures which are recognized by the E.J. Cohen. Okay, first one is called as the coccus. Coccus means what? See, it represents the spherical or the oval structure. Okay, oval structure which is called as the coccus, or single if it is there, it is called cocci. Okay, now another one is the bacillus, which is a rod shaped. Okay, it is a rod shaped. So such is called as the bacillus, or singly it is called bacilli. Then next is the spirillum. Okay, so spirillum is basically, it is spiral shaped. Okay, like this spiral, so it is called as spirillum. Then finally vibrio, which is a comma shaped. Okay, which is a comma shaped. Okay, comma shaped. So this is a vibrio. Now let's talk of the arrangement. If you look after the arrangement of these cocci or the bacilli, it can be of different types. Okay, on the basis of arrangement we can classify them. Okay, so let's see about the classification of the cocci. So first, okay, is the cocci. Now if cocci or a single coccus is found, it is called cocci. If they are two in number, like this, two cocci, they are adjacent to each other, then they are referred as the diplococcus or the diplococci. Diplococci. Okay, now this is called diplococci. If the cocci or this spherical structure, they are formed in the chain. Okay, like this, like the chain or the beaded structure, beads which are present on a string. Okay, so such a structure is referred as streptococci. Streptococci. Okay, then if the cocci, they are present in a group of four spherical cells. Okay, like this, if the arrangement of cocci is like this, then it is called as the tetrad. Tetrad. Okay, if the arrangement of these cocci, it is 8 in number, like this, it looks 4, but when we look it, it is having the 8 number of cells, like this. Okay, so that is called as the sarcine. Okay, sarcine, or simply सार्सिना, सार्सिना और सार्सिने. इफ दिस कोकाय दे लुक लाइक द बंच ऑफ ग्रेप्स, यू नो द बंच ऑफ ग्रेप्स, ओके, इफ सच अ स्ट्रक्चर इज देयर देन इट इज कॉल्ड एज द स्टैफिलो कोकाय, स्टैफिलो कोकाय, ओके, दिस इज कॉल्ड स्टैफिलो कोकाय. दैट इज द अरेंजमेंट. नाउ दिस इज व्हाट अबाउट द कोकस, ओके, और द कोकाय. नाउ बैक्टीरिया कैन बी फॉर्म्ड इन सच अ डिफरेंट अरेंजमेंट्स, लाइक इफ सिंगल इज देयर कोकाय, डिप्लोकोकाय, स्ट्रेप्टोकोकाय इन द चेन, टेट्राड इन फोर इन नंबर, सार्सिने एट इन नंबर, ओके, देन स्टैफिलोकोकाय, दैट इज द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ कोकस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द बंच ऑफ ग्रेप्स, ओके. सो यू कैन पॉज द वीडियो एंड नोट डाउन दिस पॉइंट्स और यू कैन ड्रॉ द डायग्राम्स, ओके. सो यू कैन ऑल्सो राइट लाइक टू कोकाय चेन लाइक स्ट्रक्चर स्ट्रेप्टोकोकाय, ओके, टेट्राड मीन्स फोर कोकाय. वट एवर आई एम टॉकिंग जस्ट नोट डाउन दोज पॉइंट्स, ओके, फाइन. सो यू कैन पॉज द वीडियो एंड नोट डाउन दिस डायग्राम. लेट्स डील विद द अनदर स्ट्रक्चर, दैट इज द बैसिलाय, ओके. बैसिलाय, सो सेकेंड वन इज द बैसिलस, बैसिलस, ओके. नाउ बैसिलस ऑल्सो कैन बी सिंगली प्रेजेंट, देन इट इज कॉल्ड बैसिलाय. इफ दे आर प्रेजेंट इन टू इन नंबर, ओके, टू बैसिलाय दे आर अटैच, दैट मीन इट इज कॉल्ड एज द डिप्लो बैसिलाय, ओके. नाउ इफ द बैसिलाय दे आर प्लेस्ड वन अबव अदर लाइक दिस, और दे आर फॉर्म्ड इन द बंच, यू कैन से. सो सच अरेंजमेंट इज कॉल्ड एज द पैलिसेड बैसिलस, पैलिसेड बैसिलस. Then, sometimes they are also formed in the form of ribbon-like structure, okay, or which is also referred as the streptobacilli. So they are formed in the chain. Okay, such a structure is called as the streptobacilli. Streptobacilli. Okay. So this is what about the bacillus. Now another one was the third one was the third one was the spirillum. Okay. So I'm writing over here. Third one was the spirillum. So they are having a helical or spiral structure. Okay, like this. And they may have the flagella at their end. So flagella are the locomotory structures. Okay, so such a structure is seen in the spirillum. Okay, then next another one was the vibrio. Okay, so vibrio, basically you might be heard of a disease called cholera, vibrio cholera. Okay, it is caused by this bacterium which is a comma shaped structure, which has a comma shape, you know the comma. Okay, so comma shaped structure is there which is called as the vibrio. Okay, so these are the arrangement or the shape of the bacteria, okay, which are found in the environment. Fine, so these are the different four different structure or the shapes which were identified by E.J. Cohen. Okay, so this is what about it. The next, the basic structure of a bacterial cell. Okay, so basic structure of bacterial cell includes the cell envelope. Okay, so let's talk of the cell envelope. Later we'll discuss about the further more points. Okay, so here you can pause the video and note down the points. Okay, next is the basic. Give a heading, basic structure of prokaryotic cell or basic structure of bacterial cell. Bacterial cell. Okay, so it includes cell envelope. It includes cell envelope. Now, cell envelope means what? See here, it is the outermost covering. Okay, if you look after the structure of bacterial cell, at that time we'll come to know what is cell envelope basically. Okay, so let's draw the diagram so that we can understand it clearly. Okay, so here you are supposed to draw the diagram. Diagram is about. Plasma membrane, okay, then this is the cell wall, okay, so cell wall over here, it is a thick one, so it is a cell wall. Okay, cell wall can also be referred as the capsule, okay, or the cell envelope, you can also call it as a cell envelope. Okay, the next, there is a presence of the fat drops over here, that is around the plasma membrane, there is a presence of the fat drops. So what we know that cell membrane, it is made up of the lipopolysaccharides as well as the phospholipids. These are the fat drops. Okay, then this is the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm. Okay, the next, some proteins within the cytoplasm. Okay, then there will be presence of the ribosomes. Okay, and here the structure is called the mesosome, which has been formed by the invagination of the plasma membrane. So this is the mesosome. Sometime the bacterial cell may possess the flagella. Okay, so it may have the flagella. Okay, it may have the flagella. So basically your cell wall, okay, or your cell envelope which is the outermost, okay, which is the outermost over here, that is next to the cell wall. There is a cell envelope, okay, that is the cell envelope. Now the cell envelope, it is composed of two components, okay. The cell envelope is composed of two components, that is called as the glycocalyx, okay. So it is the outermost layer, okay, it is outermost layer, and chemically, and it is outermost layer, fine, which forms a thick layer, or it is outermost thick layer around the bacterial cell wall, that is called glycocalyx, and found in the bacteria only. The next, this glycocalyx, it forms mucilaginous layer, means a kind of mucus like coating is present on the capsule or on the cell wall of the bacterial cell, or a slimy layer, which is called as a slimy layer, fine. It is called as the glycocalyx. It is composed of glycocalyx. Another component of the cell envelope is the cell wall, okay, is the cell wall. Second component is the cell wall, okay. Now cell wall in the bacteria may be composed of different components, okay. Generally in the case of bacteria, it is composed of the murine, okay, murine, which is also referred as the peptidoglycan, okay. That is the cell wall composition of the normal bacteria, but some bacteria, they may have their cell wall composition differently, okay. Like if we take an example of a disease causing bacteria called Mycobacterium tuberculi, which causes the tuberculosis, okay, as well as the Mycobacterium leprae. So here Mycobacterium, this bacterium, they have the cell wall composition as the mycolic acid, okay, they have the mycolic acid as a cell wall composition. But here in case of the bacteria, normal bacteria, that is the example, you can take an example of the Escherichia coli, E. coli, okay, they have the peptidoglycan as a cell wall component, which is also called as the murine, okay. And peptidoglycan, we can write here peptidoglycan, it is made up of two components, that is the N-acetylglucosamine and N-acetylmuramic acid, okay, NAG and NAM, that is N-acetyl, I'll write here, N-acetylglucosamine, glucosamine, okay, and N-acetyl muramic acid, Now what is that N-acetyl muramic acid one and N-acetyl glucosamine? See, these are the cross-linking polymers, okay. So these are formed in a cross-linking polymer, or they form a mesh or a network, okay, which has been present in the bacterial cell wall. Now if the composition of peptidoglycan is more, okay, in case of the bacterial cell wall, then such bacteria are referred to be the gram-positive bacteria, okay. So here a scientist called Ancien Gram has discovered a technique to classify the bacteria into two different types, that is the gram-positive bacteria and gram-negative bacteria, okay. So there is a method called the differential staining method, okay, which includes the gram staining method. In this gram staining method, we can stain the bacterial cell with the help of certain dyes, you know, dyes which are used for coloring, okay. So here there are two basic dyes are used, okay, that is the safranin and the crystal violet. So these dyes are there which are supposed to, okay, supposed to be absorbed with the help of the layer of peptidoglycan. If more peptidoglycan is there, more peptidoglycan is there, then it will absorb the violet color, that is crystal violet, and it is referred as the gram positive bacteria. And if it will absorb more safranin, okay, that is a pink colored dye, then it will be referred as the gram negative bacteria. Okay, so there is a step by step mechanism to understand the gram's nature of the bacteria. Okay, so that we'll be discussing in the next part. Fine. So till then you have to remember, or you have to recollect the points, okay, of the cell envelope, glycocalyx, cell wall. Okay, so I'll provide you the some text part, as well as you have to draw the diagram of the previous what we say, the arrangement of the cocci bacilli. Okay, till then you have to remember this part. Later in the next part we'll be discussing about the further structures. Okay, that is the cell membrane is there, and cytoplasm, within the cytoplasm what type of components are there, then we'll talk about the flagella, then we'll talk about the pili, these are the sex pili, which are how they are helping in the reproduction of the bacteria. Okay, what type of reproductive methods they are involved in the reproduction of the bacteria. Okay, whether they have the sexual, asexual type of reproduction, that we'll see. Okay, so this is what about the some introductory part of the prokaryotic cell. Okay, if I hope you have understood this. Thank you.